Welcome back to YouTube Space New York. I'm Jessica from CompChomp, and I'm here on Native Lang talking about the amazing intersection between language and code. You should be excited because we're talking about passwords today, and why your password probably isn't as good as you think it is. I love cookies, but while they make the world's best dessert, my apps keep rejecting chocolate chip as my password. I will show you who's weak. So I have to capitalize a letter, add a number, maybe throw in some geometric shapes and secret Illuminati symbols. Whew, finally, an acceptable password. But I am never going to remember it. So why the internets give me the runaround? How exactly did passwords stop being, well, words? Welcome to CompChomp, the only show on the internet where, shh, secrets. In ye olden days, the passwords worked a little differently. You would walk up to that creepy eye slit thingy, and the peeper behind there would slide it open, and you had one shot to say the magic word. But now, you can just sit there spamming that peeper with words. You can throw unpronounceable non-words at him, and you can even knock on that door from anywhere in the entire world, because that eye slit is an innocent input box, and the peeper behind it is a computer. And to computers, words are nothing special. They're just boring old strings. Characters appearing one after another after another after, you get it. So this is a valid string, but so is this, and even this, which is an empty string. There are so many possibilities! But you know who doesn't actually see a string full of possibilities here? The humans, like you, and maybe me. We fall back on our intuitive natural language to come up with strings that mean something to us, because we'd like to remember our passwords. And if we're lucky, we might get super clever and, like, swap a letter for a number. Behold my brilliance! I took that 3 and used it as an E. But you know what? More often than not, you are exactly as clever as the next guy, and you're busy patting yourself on the back for that. Don't believe me? Just look at this list of most common passwords. If you're one of the wannabe spies who used trust no one, that's gotta hurt. Kind of felt like you came up with that one all on your own, didn't it? All is not lost. If your password is on that list, you can fix it. It is time for you to do what programmers call getting entropy. No, get your mind out of the gutter. That is computer speak for being less predictable. And how do you become less predictable? By being random. Randomness, guys, woo! You know what, maybe the next time you snooze your alarm and you wake up late, you should just tell your boss you were trying to get some entropy. Probably won't work and you might get fired, but at least we'll all have a good laugh. And the reason that you needed that entropy is because password hackers are getting better and better at predicting even things that seem totally unpredictable. You can't keep hiding behind those little dots and asterisks. I have so much trouble saying the word asterisks. Trust no one tried to outwit them with a clever spelling and a complex character. But why not just make your password longer? In password cracking tests done by one senior security consultant, an 8-character password took 8 days to crack. Adding just one extra character bumped that time up to 750 days. And 11 characters, that might take, get this, 17,000 years. That makes your bank account a little safer. It's a long time for someone to try to get the $1.50 that's left in my bank account. The thing is that it might take 17,000 years, because predicting is actually about probability. Look, a hacker could randomly decide to start by guessing trust no 2, but they're gonna go with that list of shame that includes trust no 1, and they're gonna crack trust no 1 before trust no 2, even if it's just, like, right before, because you know that the next sucker whose password is getting hacked is trust no 2. Length and funny characters, they aren't the only things that make something guessable. Take a look at this. It's a nice, random, hard-to-guess string, right? Totally, totally not. There is a pattern here. Can you guess it? Can you guess it? Stop trying to guess with your eyes and guess with the eyes of your fingers instead. Ta-da! This is not the entropy that you were looking for. So, look. I know how much it hurts to have to change your password every 90 days. You can't reuse a previous password, you can't use real words, blah, 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 blah. I definitely feel it too. But there is a good reason why passwords aren't real words anymore. It's not because your computer hates English or because the programmer that made that program really likes to give you the runaround and make you play the password recovery game every 90 days. It's because words are predictable. Subscribe to keep up with me and see more of the code behind our everyday lives. Chime.